Hi students, how are you all? Hope you all are good at home, listening all the videos. I am social science teacher, your class teacher, Miss Logan Aigi. You remember me? Yes. Last week we learnt our lesson, history lesson number 1, the period of transition, Renaissance, Reformation. Okay, learnt Industrial Revolution, some of the definitions. Did you memorize anything? Yes. Anytime you should be able to recite. Okay, again read and keep it in your mind. There is nobody is asking you, no one is asking you to tell immediately, but you should keep it in your mind. Anytime it will be helpful for you. By the way, many of you sending your homework, good. Some of you copying and sending, no, and use your proper capital letters, the correct place. I want all the cursive handwriting for all assignments. Yes. Okay, this week we are going to learn one geography lesson number 6. We are not learning lesson number 1 because there are many maps in this geography book. We should learn one map at least in one term, first term. So first itself I am going to teach you one map, then second term other maps are there, we'll learn. Okay, yes. Now we'll go to Asia, the physical features and the political locations of Asia. Asia is one of the continent, largest continent in the world. Okay, yes, there are 7 continents, you remember. This is one of the continent. Asia is bounded by the Indian Ocean in the south and Pacific Ocean in the east and the Arctic Ocean in the north and the Caspian Sea and the Ural Mountains in the west. Okay, now can you see immediately? You have to locate this. We cannot explain anything in this, just you have to locate. Okay, bounded by Indian Ocean in the south. This is Indian Ocean in the south, Arctic Ocean in the north, Ural and Caspian Sea in the western side, Ural Mountain. This is, it separates Europe and Russia. In the middle, one mountain range is there, that is Ural Mountain. It separates both the continents. So we keep this is the western border of Asia and Caspian Sea, and this side, the eastern side, the Pacific Sea Ocean. Okay, north Arctic Ocean, south Indian Ocean, western side Ural Mountain and Caspian Sea, and the eastern side Pacific Ocean. Now you remember the boundaries of Asia. Okay, now we'll come to the political division of Asia. This, can you see the countries? India, China, Russia, Mongolia, Kazakhstan, Saudi Arabia. Yes, we can't learn everything together, so they are separated as a divisions of the according to the direction. Okay, this we call south. This is north. This is north part, south part. So South Asia, this is not exactly south, but is little east side. So we call Southeast Asia. This is East Asia, fully this side, no? East side. So East Asia, this is Western Asia, west side. Western Asia, West Asia. This is central part of Asia, Central Asia. So 5 divisions I told you: South Asia, Southeast Asia, East Asia, South Asia, Southeast Asia, and this is eastern side, East Asia, west side, West Asia, Central Asia. Okay, so now some of the countries we are going to learn in this, I mean locate in this. So by like that, you have to memorize the countries' names, which side in South Asia, what are the countries are there? India, Nepal, Bangladesh, yes, Bhutan, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, Maldives, even Afghanistan, this all in South. Okay, South Asia. So like that you have to, this is easy to for us to say immediately, no, you can identify. So every part of Asia you are going to identify the countries. Now shall we read this? Okay, Southeast Asia: Myanmar, Malaysia, Thailand, Singapore, Cambodia, Vietnam, Laos, Indonesia, Brunei, East Timor and the Philippines. Okay, these are the countries we read now. Okay, Myanmar, Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore, Indonesia, Philippines. Can you see these countries? These all countries we call south east asia so memorize this word these names and locate the place in different colors in your political map okay that is our work we have to do next one is south asia that I read no india pakistan bangladesh afghanistan sri lanka nepal bhutan and maldives this is easy for us because we are nearing all the country okay surround us this countries are surrounded by all nearby india okay afghanistan pakistan india nepal bhutan bangladesh sri lanka maldives okay and we see this all we call south asia division next we go to the east asia japan north korea south korea taiwan china mongolia this all east asia east side okay can you see japan north korea south korea taiwan china these all countries we call east side so east asia okay even mongolia also part of that okay next we'll go to west asia saudi arabia iraq iran syria jordan lebanon yemen israel kuwait united arab emirates qatar oman bahrain turkey can you see this all country this all we call gulf countries yes this is this side can you see yemen oman saudi arabia turkey syria iran iraq yes this part all we call them west asia then what about this all we call them central asia okay see this little hard this names for you kazakhstan kyrgyzstan tajikistan turkmenistan uzbekistan can you repeat after me kazakhstan kyrgyzstan Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, and Uzbekistan. These are the countries. You see, can you see Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, Uzbekistan, Turkmenistan? This can you see this part? Yes, this part we say Central Asia. Then what about Russia and Turkey? Yes, it belong to Europe also. It belong to Europe also and Asia also. Both the countries belong to. Both the continent okay Russia and Turkey okay these are the divisions of political division you should mark this map as your political division okay this is the map for you you find out the places and mark yes I'll give this photo of a map in your book you can go blow and see and mark like this and make it color north korea south korea japan and I didn't mark taiwan okay philippines some of the things I left something I made but you have minutely you say which you can write right otherwise put a arrow and write like this okay out of this okay don't use blue color inside the land because water only in blue color cs means caspian sea okay as means aral sea okay aral sea can you see yes that all you can mark in your political map okay now this is important thing you should know in your asia continent of extreme this asia has all kind of extremes shall we learn something you have to learn this on your own it's very easy just it's a fact general knowledge that's all it means asia has the world highest mountain peak mount everest lowest land depression dead sea okay here we can see the mount everest in nepal okay yes that is in nepal nearby india and dead sea it's here in the gulf country in the corner we can see the dead sea that is the deepest land depression okay deepest part and the highest part that a contrast okay that is opposite to each other same continent it has next it means asia has recorded the lowest temperature in Verkhoyansk -70 degrees in russia and the highest temperature in jakobabad in 50 degrees celsius in pakistan that you know pakistan very well here only highest temperature recorded this is in Pakistan in russia in the northmost side Verkhoyansk range is there only we can have the lowest point of -70 degrees of celsius of cold okay next Asia has the largest lake, Caspian Sea, and the deepest lake, Lake Baikal. That both in Asia only. Okay, largest lake also they call Caspian Sea, and deepest lake, Lake Baikal. It receives the highest average rainfall at Mion Syndrome in Meghalaya. That is in India. In India, the northeast states receives the highest rainfall in the world. Okay, so that we have proudly we can see in India only we are receiving more rainfall. That means throughout the year they have rainfall. Mion Syndrome in Meghalaya. In before that the one place was there. When I was student, I learned Sirapunji as the annual rainfall, highest average rainfall place. Okay, now they changed. That means the place changed. Every time they get this place only getting rain. Okay, next, many of the places are dry throughout the years, even in Asia, some of the place. Natural vegetation, moss, tiny vegetation, mosses, lichens, which grow in the snowy places. And even the largest delta, even forest there in evergreen forest there in our Asia. Okay, this is one of the great thing. The largest delta in the world, Ganga Brahmaputra Delta, is in this continent, that is especially in India. Okay, and the plateau of Tibet is highest and the largest plateau in the world. There are many plateaus in the world already. You know what is plateau? Is a table land. The land is slightly abruptly, it goes up, and on the top it won't be like mountain, it will be like a table. Okay, so that is we call plateau. That kind of that plateau, highest plateau located in Tibet near China. Okay, so this is about the continent of extremes. All kind of extremes we can see. One more time we can see Mount Everest, the highest peak, and land depression, Dead Sea, lowest place in the world, and Verkhoyansk in the -70°C in Russia, and Jacoba Bay is the highest temperature, 50°C in Pakistan. Asia has the largest lake, deepest lake, and it has the place Mion Syndrome. In throughout the year it's raining, so it's in Meghalaya in India, and the largest delta it's in India, that is Ganga Brahmaputra Delta. Plateau of Tibet, highest plateau in the world, that is plateau Tibet, it's in nearby India, it's in Tibet. Okay, so this part you should know. We learnt boundaries of Asia, and we learnt continent of extreme, that what kind of features in the continent. Next we learnt the political divisions of Asia. Next we are going to learn the physical features of Asia. Okay, we learn about the physical features of Asia. Okay, can you see the light yellow color? The northern lowlands. These are the northern lowlands. Okay, you have to do this map in a outline map of Asia. Okay, just a color, the map will be plain, so you can color. Okay, yes, this is the northern lowlands, all plains. We can see the plains. Okay, here you see this West Siberian plain. Okay, yes, this all. Next one is Central Mountain Belt. This all dark color is full of mountains. Here only we have Himalaya, Hindu Kush, Karakoram, all kind of mountains and plateaus, even some highlands. Okay, ranges. Next we see the southern plateaus, that is in light yellow color. Okay, southern plateaus, Arabian plateau, here Deccan plateau, here Shan and Yunnan plateau. These three plateau we can see here, plateaus. Okay, next one is the river valley, green color river valley. This is Ganga Brahmaputra valley, Mekong valley, Hongwong valley. This all valleys nearby the river, the place is very fertile. Okay, that is basins. Next you see the island groups in the color of pink. Okay, the pink color island groups. Yes, these are the island in the like Malaysia near Singapore, Sumatra, Java, Indonesia, Philippines. This all, even this islands of Andaman, Nicobar, Lakshadweep, everything is belong to the island group, that is in light pink color. So these are the divisions of physical divisions of Asia. Okay, can we list again once again? Northern lowlands, central mountain, southern plateaus, river valleys, island groups. Okay, okay. Now we'll come to know about the northern lowlands. This is the picture of the northern lowland, the Siberian, West Siberian plain. Okay, I'll show you some more of the. See, can you see the West Siberian plain? This all green color, all we call plains. Okay, Siberia, near Siberia, around everything green in color. Okay, can you see this all part? It extends from the Ural mountain to ends in river. Okay, big lowland, that is northern lowland, that we call that plain. Okay, yes, can you see here and there all green color, we call that plain. But especially this up part, the west side and north side, more we can see the northern lowland. Next one we see this central mountain belt. This is the central mountain belt. Can you see the map here? Exactly in the middle of the continent, full of mountains. Okay, can you see the mountain near Turkey? Okay, here Armenian knot. Can you see the thing? This is the point of the mountain. From there, like branches, it's going. Okay, same thing here in India. Nearby India is a Pamir knot. Can you see this? Yes, this all you can see in the dark color line. This all mountain ranges. Okay, these are the mountain ranges. Okay, we'll learn some of the ranges. This mountain system has the Pamir knot and the Armenian knot, and number of young fold mountain ranges radiate in all direction from the Pamir knot. This is the Pamir knot. From here, the number of ranges are moving everywhere, especially everything from this place only, the dark brown place. This only they are showing directly to closer. Okay, yes. Next we see this southern plateaus. I told you southern plateaus. This is in Arabia one plateau, in India one plateau. This is Deccan plateau, where we are living. We are living on the plateau only. This is Yunnan and Shan plateau, nearby this Southeast Asia. Okay, can you see this part? Yes, this is the plateau of Arabia. This is the plateau of Deccan. This is the part of the plateau of Yunnan and Shan. Okay, we'll read about that. The Arabia plateau is a dry desert region, no, with no rivers. It has a steep slope along the coast of Red Sea. Okay, can you see the Red Sea? Yes, this is the Red Sea. Along the coast of this, we have the plateau of Arabia. There is no river in this. Next we go to Deccan plateau of India. The Deccan plateau of India rises steeply and slopes gently from the west to east. This plateau is cut by a large number of eastward flowing rivers such as Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri. Yes, this is the place you see, west to east. This is the plateau. The rivers are flowing from here to east. Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, Mahanadi. Can you see this? This is in India. Next one is Shan and Yunnan, the plateau. The plateau and the of Myanmar and China respectively. It's there in the Myanmar and China, nearby here. Okay. Yes. Now we'll go to the next one, the river valley. What is the next one? River valley. We'll go to the river valley. That is, can you see the green part? Ganga, Brahmaputra, Hongo. Is this all part, and we are going to read about that. First one is a Mesopotamian plain. Okay, formed by the Tigris and Euphrates rivers. Okay, in Iraq. This is the one, this is the place. Mesopotamian river valley, Iraq, the place. And two rivers are Euphrates and Tigris. Okay, next one is Indus plain, formed by the Indus river and the five tributaries of Pakistan. Okay, this is the one they are telling, Indus river. Okay, Ravi, Satluj, five rivers, Jhelum. We see the five rivers here, and there only we call this river valley. Near river, the place we call fertile place, basin. Okay, next one is, the third one is Ganga Brahmaputra plain, formed by the Ganga and Brahmaputra rivers in India and Bangladesh. Yes, this is the one. India and Bangladesh till year. Okay, next one is the Great Eastern Plains in China are formed by the Hongwo, Changjiang and the Sikyong rivers. These are the rivers flows here. Okay, this is in China, Mongolia nearby. Okay, yes, these are the four plains we see. Okay, and three plateaus we saw, that is Arabian Plateau, Deccan Plateau and the Plateau of Shan and Yunnan. And these are the four plains. And the next we are going to see the island groups. Okay, the several groups of island lie towards the east and the south east of mainland of Asia. Okay, the many groups we see in the southeast side of mainland of Asia, that means this here by southeast Asia, these are all the islands which are in the water, surrounded by all side water, the piece of land we call island. Okay, so some of the islands are, there are major islands, three major islands groups, namely Japan, Philippines, Indonesia. The Malay archipelago is the largest island group in the world. Okay, these are the places, many islands together we call archipelago. Okay, many small islands together we call that name. So Malaysia nearby, many islands are there, Indonesia, Philippines, everything we call island group. Now you understand something. Now can you see the map here? This is the physical map. In this map only, I took and wrote some of the things. Yes, it's a little hard to find here, but can you see here? Easily you can make it out. Plateau of Arabia, Plateau of Iran, Caspian Sea, Ural Mountains, West Siberian Plain, Verkhoyansk Range means mountain, Mongolian Plateau, Gobi Desert, Plateau of Tibet, River Hongho, River Changjiang, Himalayan Range, Ganga River, Yamuna River, River Indus, okay, River Mekong. These are the places you have to mark in your physical map. I'll give a photo of this. You mark as it is, and all the mountain ranges you have to mark with brown color, plateaus with yellow color, river with a little light blue color. On the river only you just draw a line, that's all. Don't draw more color, don't color more with blue inside the land. And plains you have with green, basins green. Yes, you can make this. Yes, the question answers for this lesson. Small short answers, list the physical divisions of Asia. This is the physical divisions of Asia. Okay, northern lowlands, central mountains and southern plateaus, river basins or river valleys and island groups. Okay, next one, describe the river basins of India. You should know about the four river basins. Some mountain names you should know. Okay, many mountains I showed you in the map, and you can write a note on island groups. What are the three plateaus of Asia? Three plateaus in the Asia. Okay, detailed answer. Why do we call the Asia is a continent of extremes? You should write the all the features, the special features of Asia, and list, and second one, list the political divisions of Asia. We learnt to know South Asia, Southeast Asia, East Asia, West Asia, some countries name. You have to list that. This is detailed answer. You must memorize this. You, with interest, you can do. You want to know the places, no? So you do with your interest. Next one, the map work. Identify the countries of Asia. This you have to list. This you have to identify. Okay, identify the physical features of Asia. You should know the physical features, that is this map. This map you should know, where is the mountain, where is the plateau, where is the river, that all you should know. Okay, yeah, once you get the book, you can come to know more. Now shall we learn the little about the new words for Asia? Eurasia, Europe and Asia together we call Eurasia, EURASIA, Eurasia. The border is Ural Mountain. Then Verkhoyansk, that is the range and the coldest place in Asia. Okay, minus 70 degrees Celsius is there. VER KHOYANSK, Verkhoyansk. Myaw syndrome, the wettest place, rainiest place in the world. Myaw syndrome, MAWSYNRAM. Next, Ganga Brahmaputra Delta, that is the largest river valley in the world. Plateau of Tibet, highest plateau in the world. Malay Archipelago, it's a group of island nearby Malaysia. Gobi Desert, it's in China. Okay, Mongolian Plateau. These are the new words you learned. Okay, thank you children. Learn your video again and write the answers with interest. Without interest you can't learn. Please, with interest you learn everything. Thank you, bye.